There are some strange foods out in our world today, from weird semi-normal foods like strange pickles and soups to bugs and beyond. These are some of the weirdest foods in the world. Number 17, Tropickles. In recent years, some customers have found this strange product populating Walmart shelves. Tropickles are the cute new name of an apparently age-old food. Basically, this is a jar of tropical punch-flavored pickles. While Walmart might be the first to start stocking this item, it's actually something that was made for years in the South. The recipe involves essentially putting pickles into a vat of Kool-Aid and letting them soak. It's unclear to me exactly what mood you're supposed to be in to eat this. Number 16, Toasted Tarantula. This is a dish that might help you overcome your arachnophobia, or make it a lot worse. This regional delicacy is found in Cambodia and is essentially a heaping helping of deep-fried tarantula, or aping. Since a single tarantula rivals the size of an average human palm, it serves as a pretty shocking and intriguing tourist attraction. Visitors usually just want pictures of the unusual food, but others will take a dare to chow down on the spiders. Many countries outside of the US will bolster their diet with insects and arachnids, so it's really not that uncommon to find some grilled bugs in the East. Most meals comprised of little bugs are actually packed with nutrients, especially protein. But how do they taste? Some say it tastes like chicken, but perhaps with a bit more crunch. Number 15, Surströmming. Originating in Sweden, here's a food that might sound a bit fishy, and smell that way too. Understandable, given that it's a type of herring from the Baltic Sea that's been heavily fermented, but it's given just enough salt to ward off decomposition. Still, this food item is often referred to as rotten fish, and it merits the title. Japanese study concluded that a newly opened can of surströmming contains the foulest stench of any food on Earth. Suffice to say, this one is definitely an acquired taste and smell. Number 14, Kazu Marzu. Found mainly in Sardinia, this is a traditional cheese made from sheep milk that contains live insect larvae, or maggots. That, along with the fact that the name Kazu Marzu translates into English as rotten or putrid cheese, doesn't exactly give it an appetizing quality. Thanks to the larva of the cheese fly, the food goes beyond fermentation and begins to decompose due to the insect's digestive qualities. In fact, the larvae are introduced just for this purpose, to digest the cheese's fats, allowing it to become soft enough for liquid to seep out. It's eaten with the maggots still alive, and sometimes the white, worm-like creatures can become disturbed enough to launch themselves some 6 inches. Number 13, Bird's Nest Soup. In Chinese culture, this is a delicacy made from an edible bird's nest. The nest is that of a swiftlet, a tiny bird that builds its home out of saliva that dries up into a hard material. Once constructed, the nests are prized for their rarity and exquisite flavor. Once it's dissolved into the soup, the nest takes on a more gelatinous texture. Most of the flavor, however, does not come from the nest, but rather the flavor added into the broth. The savory and sweet dish has been prepared in China for hundreds of years, and eating it denotes a sense of luxury and class. There are a number of varieties that come with steep price tags thanks to their rarity. A kilogram of the Red Nest variety can cost as much as $10,000, making it among the most expensive foods on Earth. Number 12, Escamoles. Ant larvae that have been harvested from the root of the agave plant are sometimes referred to as insect caviar. The white shapes might look like rice, but they're actually the huge eggs of ants that are said to have a taste that is nutty and buttery. It's considered a delicacy in Mexico, where it's been served up since the time of the Aztecs. Number 11, Hákarl. The national dish of Iceland is actually a Greenland shark that has been fermented for months at a time. Because it contains a large amount of ammonia, it has the pungent smell of many cleaning products. The ammonia smell is actually much stronger than its actual taste, so any newbies to the food are advised to pinch their nose and hold their breath as they try it. Even with that advice in hand, many non-natives would describe the food as the worst thing they have ever eaten. The faint of heart should definitely not try this one out. Number 10, Hakuta. This strange dish has also been referred to by others as Alaskan ice cream. Some of the ingredients in this dish might seem weird for ice cream. Traditionally, it's made with whipped fat that's mixed with various berries, including cranberries and blueberries. Along with fat from local critters like reindeer, the dish can also include sugar, milk, and fish. It might even include tundra greens and root inside. Once served up, it's said to have a cold and creamy texture, not unlike ice cream. Number 9, Baby Mice Wine. In China, this isn't known for being an alcoholic beverage as it is for being a health tonic, albeit one that is little known, maybe for a good reason. The concoction is composed of hairless, dead infant rodents, presumably because the mature ones with fur would seem strange. The baby mice cannot be more than 3 days old, then are placed, while still alive, into a bottle of rice wine, where they are left to ferment for the next 14 months. Number 8, Ballad. While balut is commonly sold in the streets of the Philippines as a delicacy, many people in the West are probably not prepared for this strange culinary experience. This is not your standard boiled egg. It's the semi-developed egg of a duck that has an actual embryo on the inside of it. If you're not prepared to find an actual bird in your late-night snack, you'd be in for a shock. But for Filipino citizens, it's just another savory snack served with a sprinkling of salt. You might have even seen balut used as a shock factor outside of the Philippines, as it's commonly used in reality TV as a stunt or punishment for contestants to eat. While it might be visually shocking, taste is actually quite tame. It tastes like boiled egg with a bite or two of actual chicken inside. Number 7. Tipa. These little guys are also known as stinkheads because of the pungent smell they exude after being fermented for so long. Whitefish of king salmon heads and guts are placed within plastic or wooden barrels that are draped in burlap, then buried in the ground for up to 7 days or more. By the time the heads are harvested, they have decomposed into one big lumpy mash of matter. It's considered a delicacy and is a staple in the diet of native Alaskans. So yes, tipa is essentially rotten fish head pudding, which is not exactly within the palate of most Westerners, making it infamous among food travel shows and bloggers as a gross food. Number 6. Kopi Luwak. Coffee lovers beware. If you're truly a caffeine junkie, you might have heard of this high-end brew. Kopi Luwak is also known as civet coffee, after the small mammal that's native to Southeast Asia and from which this coffee is made. The little animal feasts exclusively on coffee beans, which it partly digests, then excretes. Any coffee can become Kopi Luwak as long as it's processed through the animal. While one could say that drinking a cup of this coffee would be pretty crappy, it remains the most expensive coffee in the world. Retail prices can reach some $700 per kilogram. Number 5. Mongolian Budok. You might call this one a type of Mongolian barbecue created by nomads. They found a way to cook an entire goat from the inside out. The process involves hanging the animal upside down and then stuffing its body cavities with heated stones. Roasting it over an open fire completes the process and you're ready to dig in. Number 4. Sinakji. You say you like your seafood served raw? You might like to try this Korean delicacy. The long arm octopus is killed and seasoned literally seconds before being served up. However, because of the complex nervous system of an octopus, while it's served up at the table, it continues to twitch and swirl around as if it were alive. Despite being completely dead, you'll find that a bite of sinakji would be just as hard as trying to swallow a live octopus. The suckers tend to stick to your tongue, cheeks, and roof of your mouth, so it requires a bit of chewing, to say the least. Despite, or maybe because of the strange experience of eating this dish, it has remained a relatively common Korean dish for centuries. Some even consider it a health food. Number 3. Haggis. This is likely one of the better known unusual foods on the list. From Scotland, haggis is famous for, or infamous, for arriving at your dinner table encased within a sheep's bladder. In fact, the food consists of a savory pudding that is made from the animal's heart, liver, and lungs, then combined with salt, spices, and onion mixed with stock. Many people can be put off by that description, but haggis is said to have a delicious flavor and a pleasant, savory texture. We'll take their word for it. Number 2. Deep fried butter. It truly does not get more American than this carnival food. Deep fried butter is pretty much exactly what it says on the box. Butter is frozen into hard lumps, traditionally round shapes, and then dipped into batter and quickly dumped into a piping hot vat of oil. It is then doused in powdered sugar and then chocolate, vanilla, or strawberry syrup. If you truly want to eat like an American, what's a better way than this dish that's fat on fat on fat on fat? Number 1. Ruby Chocolate. Here's a strange turn of events that could only happen in the 21st century. Scientists have developed an entirely new breed of chocolate. Swiss engineers have created this millennial pink cacao bean, dubbed Ruby Chocolate. It is unclear whether this new chocolate gets its flavor and color from a new processing technique, or if it was bred and developed from the ground up. It is distinguished by an uncanny berry-like flavor and smoothness. Kit Kat has debuted the chocolate with a new limited edition bar called Sublime Ruby Kit Kat, which retails for about $17.